example, like the last festival we did, the village festival, for the newcomer, especially foreigner, we handed out the ethic code. So they should be mindful of us. Yeah, but it's still ongoing, and I think what we're interested in is like keep pushing a bit. So for example, like the rooftop of the project, you know, there is not really consensus that people want something on the rooftop, but we still do, because I think for me, I believe that if they see something, they may change their mind by respond or something. So we try, you know, and if it fails, it fails, it's fine. But we will try. You know.
So they no longer wanted to tear down the building?
Before the government, they said that, oh, this building is not safe, we will, you know, people have to evacuate, live in another place and all. So this is like years of this tension between the government and the residents. But the latest information was the government offered a relocation plan, compensation of relocation, that they moved to somewhere a little bit out of town. But most of the residents, they do not want to, because it's so far, no infrastructure support where that place is, and far from their work and the school of their kids, so it will cost a lot more for them to be living that far. So they're not happy, so they do not agree. So now it's still, there's no agreement. But also along the way, there's a private company who started to buy small apartments from the neighborhood as well. And what we worry is that they will soon buy the apartment we rent. Because they're smart. I think they want to kill the key hub of the community function. Yeah? So one, they already bought one apartment of the community school. So now the community school is shrinking. It's becoming smaller. And then the other day they went to come and check our archive room. So we might need to find a new apartment.
Redevelopment.
Yeah. Question, comment, suggestion. Did I speak okay? Not too fast.
Okay.
I'm just curious.
Yes.
Why you should work in with the community?
What?
Why?
Why?
What's the reason?
Why? Oh, okay. What's the reason? Yeah, the reason came out first because there are other art galleries already in the city. And the people who can see art or can sort of like access art, a certain audience who, you know, educated audience, they go to see exhibition and gallery. So we thought about other audience, like simple audience, people who not so like, you know, educated or something, that can we engage them with art as well, something like this. So we see that as an opportunity for us to find a new way to engage art with the audience. And it's just that because of many reasons of that location of that site and the community in that, so it sort of helped inform us about, you know, if our site is there, location is there, it must make sense. Space and the activity of the project should make sense and connect with the community that we stay at.
So there are other not a group who do something like
In Phnom Penh, we are the only artists run sort of like experimental space. The rest are galleries, exhibition, and art studio. A few, not many, a few art studios. But the art studio is not public. But there are more artist run space in Battambang province, in the north, which is the other sort of art hub city in Cambodia. So in Cambodia, there are two art hub cities. One is Phnom Penh and one is Battambang province. And Battambang province, because largely there is a big art school there, it's a non-profit art school. You know, far from New Salopak. Actually, the biggest art school, even though it's not public, a state university, but it's really a big. And each year, many art graduates can come out from that school. And therefore, Battambang is a very, a big art community. And there are, sadly, there are not currently artist run space because the last one was closed down last month. Yeah, so I think this challenge of artist-run space like everywhere, not just Cambodia, but maybe here and other places as well, about the challenge of sustaining itself.
Is there any event like that has a negative response from the people?
From the people? So far, not really like negative. It's just a bit like skeptical. Skeptical about this sort of thing. And there's some complaints, people passing by, a lot of foreigners and people coming from outside passing by. But it's mixed because there are people who are really proud. They say they're proud that people, that other people in outside recognize their neighborhood, that that is a art neighborhood, they come and see art, so there's a recognition. So there's a people who feel proud, but people who feel skeptical. so that makes sense.
How about those students in the art project, what are they doing?
The students, now we engage in a new class. So some of the students, they started to be more like early artists. They started to be more active, making artwork and making exhibition and participate in residency in the neighborhood like Dara, also Da Nai, Rado slowly. And now we start a new contemporary art class, so bringing the senior students from our project together with students from the fine art school, graduate from fine art school, and also graduate from Fabian Salopat, a few, to join together in this contemporary art class every Sunday as a weekly session where we have sort of like two layers of the classes. One is the building project, so you develop and you make your project towards an exhibition, so at the end there will be a group exhibition. But also another layer is classes and lecture and talk and all that engage with different topics, history, art history, because I feel like I study art history, so I think something I can share, and I think artists should be also a little bit oriented and can get the benefit from art history as well. Also I want to share a class on philosophy because the relationship philosophy and art very strong. So also the idea is to push them to think more critically. Because we believe that good artists is not simply just like be able to make good art, but actually it's the way they think and how they think about society around them, you know, how they perceive the world, how they analyze the world, how they are critical to the world around them. So maybe, yes, introducing these through different sort of topics become sort of like a good learner, like a good learner.
Gentrification, like new artists to come to Europe, and finally
surprise, Greece and this other thing. Yeah. So people ask me too, like, oh, when you do the art project in there, whether you may increase the rank or the price or not. But so far no. Currently, people who live there. Artists, they have their house there, okay, already. And we who came in and rent studio, and so far there's no problem of like price increasing anything. And there is no new trend of like hip artists coming and make studio something like this. It didn't happen. It hasn't happened. No, because. I think, artists in Cambodia, they don't have sort of like the luxury of being able to pay for studio. They still use their bedroom. So they still use their house, so like, they don't have that, you know, luxury yet.
And
how
like Sasa Basak and Sasa Basak
played
a role in the
Cambodian
art?
Mm. So together, Sasa Basak is a gallery, and for us, we sort of like, we are artists of Sasa Basak. Sort of Sasa Basak represents us something. So they support us in exhibition and all and all. And Sasa Art Project is where sort of like a lab. Mm-hmm. It's sort of a lab where introduce new artists. No, hopefully produce sort of like new generation of artists. But also the way that we can engage in our art. And so when artists feel, and this is we just started, and I just curated an exhibition by two students from Sasa Art Project at Sasa Basak. Mm-hmm. So when we see that. Sort of okay, I think this they are now ready for doing something, you know, more serious, and then we sort of like move them to Sasa Basak and work with them as an artist. And financially, Sasa Basak support to Sasa Art Project through percentage of sales. So because Sasa Basak makes sales for the artwork as well, the idea is that it hopes to sustain the running of the space through sales, but currently not yet. But there's some percentage of sales go to support Sasa Art Project, and then so try to make it as sort of like a connected platform, so when the students are ready, then they can go to Sasa Basak and come support me again. And in terms of in a larger scene in Cambodia, Sasa Basak support exhibition internationally a lot these days. Making sales, to museum or institution abroad. And whereas so Art Project still the only one artist and space in Cambodia, we want more. I think there should be more and different form of engagement. So it's more interesting. But currently, unfortunately, it's the only one and the only residency program. By saying the only residency, actually. It doesn't mean that the other spaces do not do residency. The other gallery and spaces, they do residency as well, but but not ongoing, right? Maybe like 1 year they have one residency, something like this, but we are doing continuously dedicated program for residency. And how else we contribute? I don't know.
How about the university in
So we try to make connection so that it's not just us. So we want to make connection for sure. So we engage with students from the Fine Art University as well in our event and in some workshop we specifically invite them to come. And this year was the first year that we hosted a graduate from the Fine Art School at our residency program. The year before we hosted artists from Baden Baden. So we try to make connection bring on, and also this contemporary art class project is also part of that, trying to bring students from different schools, different sort of pedagogic experience to try something a little bit more together, and hopefully to create a community of students. So we have another plan, so after this one, after the contemporary art class, we want to develop this project where there is this dedicated space. It's run by students, and it's like a student community space where students can come, hang out, share, and have some special class and sessions specifically for students, for example, like making portfolio, making CV, writing artist statement, something, these simple skills that are helpful for art students. Maybe nobody asks about how we sustain ourselves. I think one of the struggles, maybe many artists run space, how we sustain ourselves. We are lucky. We are lucky. We've been running for 6 years. So at first, it was it started from a support from the artist community themselves. So they donated artwork, and then we did auction, fundraise, and then we started project, and then later we did online fundraising, Kickstarter, friends of friends and all sort of support, and some sponsorships, some support, some donation. But finally, also like grant, we applied to grant to do. But most importantly is the chance, the chance to get the grant is you do collaboration. It's better. So so I collaborate with partner, so international partners, so Australian partner, UK partner. So it expands the more the possibility of getting a grant. So so for example, from the British Council or from some Australian government grant something. So I think this is a good method, I think, and I think I suggest people too, like when they look for grant, you look for grant, it's easier to have partner and have another international partner. So then it sort of like it's it increased the credibility, like and the business can increase the credibility, but also it's good for the donors, because the donors they like to support project that hopefully has sort of more impact, so like they support different sort of partners projects. And finally, we just got a grant from a foundation that support us for 2 years, and they are very open. They support the they said you can use whatever you want. The programming, the ongoing support for programming, your staff or space or whatever, and whatever you want to do, residency or project. So very flexible, and I feel like wow, this is the best grant we have. Like you're very flexible, so we don't feel so restricted to do certain things. So because they actually proposed to for them to grant the residency project, only residency, they said they were also skeptical about residency. Skeptical about residency as a model for like engaging for art and change, try to make some change or something. So they said, do whatever you want, something, because I think they're interested in the concept of social art project overall. But the no from next year, nah.
When you apply for a grant, you have to kind of submit the report.
Yeah. We submit report. How many people? How many students? How many audience? And then this and this and this. Nah. But we should educate donors too. So for us, we give those numbers, but also we give them other information that provide more texture to the impact and something not just about numbers, something else, so they more oriented to sort of like the how they measure art project, the impact of art project, because it's hard to measure.
So administration work is in grant writing.
It's a lot, you know, and it's a lot.
And, result.
Yeah, it's a lot, and it requires skills, you know, that you have that skills. It's not like you haven't done it, and then it just like overwhelming. So it's a challenge, and I think partly because of my previous background before art, I was involved in development projects. So I'm sort of like writing project proposals. So familiar, but not in the context of art, you know, but just like familiar with the method, the form. And my background was also in communication, public communication. So I think it helps a lot in at Salsa Art Project now, because you know it helps, this skill helps you to to run things more easily. If you're not, then it's harder. It's just harder without those previous experience. So anyone interested to do residency in Cambodia can apply.
But next year you are not sure.
Not sure, Grant, but we can like hypothesis.
Okay.
We hope something. But the thing is like I think this is in the longer term. It should be like this. It should be a share economy. And I think to rely just on one sort of funding source, I think it's not happening. I think that's how it will continue to sort of like go toward that way, is that if you want to sustain, you need to look into different source of your income and look how you can generate yourself, right? For us as a Salsa Art Project, we don't generate ourselves. Currently, we don't generate money yet. But we do the residency over time to share funding source. So some artists, they apply, they may, you know, they pay for their own flight and some of money, and then we support space and some allowance, something like this, to bring together. Or if we have two partners, and I tend to also find partners who is connected to funding source. So for example, we have one partnership with a foundation in South Africa. So each year one artist will go to South Africa, and one artist from South Africa come to Cambodia, and they cover everything, or almost everything. So it's good for us. Yeah? So try to look for something like this that they can cover, and for opportunity for exchange.
Yeah. Is there any government censorship on your
projects? No, in Cambodia, well, the government they control the media. Local media are all controlled by the government. Cambodian language, Khmer language media. But in contemporary art, in general, the government doesn't have a vision on contemporary art. They do not have support, nor they don't have interest. So